What's going on, my PT peeps and my Walking Dead family? One Eye Bri back from the PT channel to talk about The Walking Dead Season 9, Rick Grimes, and how will it happen. Spoiler warning, if you don't want to know some of this information, it's a general discussion video, but we're going to hit some topics that if you don't know what we're talking about and you don't want to know, I don't want to ruin it for you, but spoiler warning for sure. Now, I love The Walking Dead, obviously, as I have a YouTube channel for it. But if you love The Walking Dead, become a member of our Walking Dead friends and family at the PT channel. I hope you do. It's easy. Just hit that subscribe button. Now, is it time for Rick to look at the flowers come season 9? Some people say no. Some people say yes. And the word is that Andrew Lincoln is leaving The Walking Dead as of season 9. I saw an article online a couple of days ago that I can't find it anymore. I think they took it down. But they said in the article that AMC is going to be coming out with a statement very, very soon regarding the news about Rick Grimes for season 9. The article came out on comicbook.com 2 or 3 days ago. Not sure what happened to it, but let's just say Rick Grimes is leaving. That's the word. I believe the word is that Rick Grimes is going to be gone as of season 9. Oh, Andrew Lincoln is leaving. And the new lead is supposed to be Daryl Dixon. And I'm hoping that it's a committee lead like Daryl, Carol, and Michonne, not just all Daryl 100%. But we'll see what happens. And I'm still enjoying The Walking Dead, and I hope you are as well. And I'm excited about season 9. I say in every video, I think, as I talk about season 9, as I am very excited for it. But how do you think Andrew Lincoln is going to leave the character of Rick Grimes? Is Rick going to die? Is he going to be killed? Is he going to be bit? Is he going to leave? Is he going to have a chance to come back? Not sure, but I don't think he would just leave the people of Alexandria. We'll see what the writers want to do, what Angela Kang wants to do, and you know Scott Gimple is going to be part of this decision. Now, Angela Kang is the showrunner for season 9. Congrats to her. I hope she does a great job, and I have faith that she can do a good job, but we'll see what happens this season and beyond. Scott Gimple is the man in charge above Angela Kang. So what's going to happen with the writer's decision for what to do with the Rick Grimes character? Now, if Andrew Lincoln's leaving and he's never coming back, how could you do anything with the character of Rick Grimes? Are you going to recast him? Are you going to kill him off? Are you going to turn him to a walker? Is he just going to fade away? Is the death going to be seen? Is it going to be drawn out? Is it going to be gruesome? Is it going to be epic? Is it going to be memorable? Is it going to be terrible? Is it going to be disappointing? So many things. What are we expecting? Not much, because I don't know what to expect. But Andrew Lincoln has been signing autographs, meeting some fans during filming. Pretty cool stuff. Andrew Lincoln is hard to meet in person and definitely hard to get a picture and an autograph with. So if you ever have the chance to do it, you should feel very, very lucky. Andrew Lincoln is a great guy. I just feel sadness in his eyes right here as he's waving to fans after a long day of filming. Not sure what's going to happen if the rumors are true that he's only going to film 6 episodes. That would be potentially the first half of season 9. Well, we'll see what happens. The other equation is Maggie Rhee. She supposedly may be gone after this season too. If Lauren Cohan is only filming 6 episodes, so is Andrew Lincoln, is it the same 6 episodes? Do their characters connect with each other as the way to go out? Like Maggie seeks revenge to kill Negan, Rick gets in the way and he is struck by Maggie or killed by Maggie by accident, where Maggie is so vengeful that she's trying to kill Negan and Rick is killed as a result of Maggie's vengeance, or Rick, something happens. I don't know. I just can't even picture that. I think that would be so crazy. I don't know if it'll work or not, but I don't want to see that. But can Rick and Maggie coexist after the decision to keep Negan alive? It could be a breaking point. You're going to have Hilltop, the Saviors, the Kingdom, and Alexandria all working together. That ain't going to work. That's not going to work for Maggie, that's for sure. But I don't want to see Maggie versus Rick or Rick versus Maggie like a civil war. I don't want to see that at all. I want to see them fighting together to go against the Whisperers. And I think the best way to do it is that the Whisperers come around and they kill Rick and Maggie, and another war is started with Daryl, Michonne, Ezekiel against the Whisperers. Now, Rick clearly couldn't save Carl. He didn't have the opportunity to do that as Carl went out on his own, helped Sadiq, with one of the weakest deaths out there, as a main character should not have been killed that way, in my opinion. Carl's death should not be replicated ever. Definitely not by a main character like Rick or Maggie or Carol or Daryl or Michonne. But Rick could not save Carl. It really wasn't Rick's doing that Carl died. It was just by chance a walker bite, and it was just some freak circumstances which should have been avoided. Sadiq and Carl could have just went around the walkers and went back to Alexandria. It didn't have to happen. But Carl's death is definitely going to impact Rick and Andrew Lincoln for sure. Chandler Riggs not being on the show is impacting Andrew Lincoln in a negative way. It's hard for him to not see Chandler Riggs and Carl on set, as Carl is Rick's son, and you know that dynamic on there. And it's a shame, and it's very sad that that decision was made by Scott Gimple. But we have to move on from it. Season 9 continues, and we'll see what happens this season for it. But you got Rick, Michonne, and Judith. Is a good dynamic there. But Rick could be trying to save Michonne and save Judith, or save somebody, and that's how he could go out. So I think two things. Rick could die saving Judith, Michonne, or somebody. And when the Whisperers come around, he could be going against them at the same time, or a horde of zombies. So, to say Alexandria is overrun by walkers. Just like in Season 6, they were trying to prevent that, but the walkers eventually came back around. The Whisperers used that same horde to bring them right into Alexandria. Judith is in danger. Michonne is in danger. Rick goes running in, takes out some walkers with his axe, with his red machete, with his Colt Python, with a machine gun, with something, an assault rifle. He's taken down walkers and he just gets overrun. Judith and Michonne get to safety, but Rick gets bit in the process. Kind of sounds like a death in the comic that I want to talk about in a second, but I just don't want Rick's death to be dumb, to be stupid, to be worthless. If it happens, it's already going to be bad enough. But I want his death to set the tone for the future of the series, so the series can live on and exist and be awesome and still continue. Now, some people are saying, when Rick dies, I ain't watching. Well, then see you later. But you'll probably still watch. But either way, if Rick's gonna leave, it's going to hurt the show. Just like Carl's death and Glenn's death and Abraham's death. Losing main characters is not good for the show. And the writers and producers need to know that, right? I'm sure they want The Walking Dead to continue on. They don't want it to end after season 9, so what are they going to do about it? We'll see. But what if Rick's death is like the comic Andrea death, where he saves someone but gets bit, and he still has time before he dies? Kind of just like the Carl death. He was bit, but he did some things with the blue paint and planted a tree and was Judith and wrote notes. But what do you think, guys? Could the Andrea death be coming to the show for Rick? It was kind of like Carl's death. The Andrea death from the comic, I mean, not the show. The comic Andrea death was her saving a fellow survivor. That could happen with Rick. Rick could get bit, maybe on the hand, maybe they have to cut his hand off, which would satisfy some comic readers, but he could still die from the infection. They didn't catch it in time. He has flashbacks, he has hallucinations, hence all the people that could possibly come back from prior seasons. But if you want to know more about the comic death of Andrea, check out issue 167, as it's a pretty sad issue. Spoiler warning for sure, but I think that could happen to Rick Grimes on the show. He dies by getting bit, saving someone. I would go with saving Judith or Michonne or someone like that. I would just like it to be linked with the Whispers, with Alpha and Beta or the Horde or something that comes around, setting up the Whisper story arc with the remaining survivors. So it's something that sets up the next story after Rick dies, because there's going to be before Rick and after Rick. It may be very short-lived after Rick dies. Hopefully we get another season or two after Rick dies or leaves or what happens with them. But what do you think, guys? Will it happen? And how will it happen? Will Rick Grimes be gone after this season, season 9 of The Walking Dead? Will he be bit? Will he die? Will he sacrifice himself? Will he just leave? Will he be killed? Will he be killed by Maggie or Negan or Alpha or Beta or none of the above? Let me know your thoughts. Post your comments below, guys. I want to know your thoughts of this for sure. Whatever happens to Rick, it's going to suck. But for those interested in my book series, Fight For Us Weaponizes Book 7, it'll be out next week, which is 4th of July. Amazon.com, BarnesandNoble.com. We're going to have paperback and digital versions for sure. Fight For Us Weaponized, which is book 7 of my book series. I'm excited, guys. Like, share, subscribe, and comment if you're new to the channel. We have a lot of fun here, and I don't want you to miss out. And remember, guys, with hard work, dedication, and belief, you can achieve your goals no matter what they are. Never give up on your goals and ideas in life. Believe in yourself. If you can dream it, you can do it.